4th Annual Farmer Fashion Show. Our first couple is Derek Avery and Jessica Rogers. Derek is wearing a beer-cut in black cable tailcoat. The gown is finely tailored to the raised double stripe and accessorized white collar shirt and a black bow tie and helmet. And mom says it looks just like Tim Allen. Besides crossing, track, he's also involved in football and basketball. We do know that he got lost at 1 a.m. trying to find Cumberland Farms. And it's very easy to see why Derek and Jessica are homecoming team queen.
Years old, she took her folks car out here and rolled it backwards down to her aunt's driveway into a stream. Mom also tells us that she was thrilled when Jess was elected president of the National Honor Society. Penn State, University of Vermont, and the University of Maryland are in Jess's future. She won't decide which one to go to, but the movie that her mom writes best describes her life as Trouble with Angels. Her mom felt that she looks just like Dorothy Gamble.
That have enhanced your life. Our crystal ball shows us you will be pursuing a career in graphic arts. Mom says you look just like your uncle and grandfather. Mike was involved in basketball, track, and volleyball while at Morse. He also likes bowling and water skiing.
Okay, Jenny Hoffman's nickname is Princess. I understand why. Steve says she broke her elbow skiing her first year out of the school when she was little. It was 2.5 days later before they realized it was broken. She held quite an accomplishment for her folks for being on the honorable Morse High School while involved in swimming, tennis, and the youth group. This crystal ball shows her modeling, and it's no wonder she looks just like Priscilla Presley, the mother felt. Princess will be going to Liberty University and majoring in nursing to be a midwife on the RN.
So much that took everyone a week to recover. Your folks are so proud of the fact that you are so independent and that you are not afraid to stand up for your rights and voice your opinions. Our crystal ball tells us that you will be going to college and majoring in accounting or studying to be a sports trainer. Movie that describes a maverick. You are great at spinnies and at lobstering and that you love to play football, basketball, and track. You have a great dog named Duke. And you look like a cross between Mike Brown, your cousin, and Charlie Holbrook. So
the fact that you made National Honor Society made your mother very proud this year. We understand that when you were at the Thompson Fair, you were in a pig scramble and caught that pig and brought it home. Do we see college and a career in elementary education in your future?
David played hide and seek with Robin Gorski SeaWorld. You got lost and had to call the police, thinking you had been abducted. And about 1 hour later, they found you all hiding in the toy box. Your mom is proud of the fact you worked so hard to graduate your class by doing summer school and night school to obtain this goal, Barbara. She thinks you're such a determined young man. The movie that best describes your high school life, Barbara, is entitled Against All Odds. Your mom felt that you were determined at this goal to graduate. Whatever you decide to do, you can do. They hope you'll be really happy and fulfilled in whatever you choose to do. We understand you look just like your brother. Go figure. Mom informed us that you had a pet lizard named Dudley, and the pet cat demolished Dudley. It seems that this cat called Tripod caused it had 3 legs to watch pet Dudley in a very tight aquarium, and scaffolded out a way to get poor Dudley. We also forgave poor Tripod. Barney, you played lacrosse, soccer, volleyball, and shot pool, but you especially like dirt biking, four-wheeling, and tinkering with remote-controlled cars. Your mom and Kevin wanted you to be reminded of those wonderful far-fetched stories Kevin would tell you that you would believe, like the fact that Kevin swam on a cross-country swim team in Greenland, Maine. And then you got so excited when you actually thought he dated the lead singer in the rock group Heart.
Rhonda Lowe, your mother writes that her nickname is Lucy Liston or Bright Eyes. When you were very young, Bright Eyes, it seems that you cut all your hair off and had a perm so that you would look just like all the nannies. Your accomplishment was told us that You have accomplished a lot by living on your own and continuing with your school and graduating with your class. It seems that West Side Story would be the best movie that would describe your high school years. It was written that you looked just like Esther Williams, and that you enjoyed watching football and basketball games and shooting pool, listening to music, and talking on the phone for hours.
Just follow that dream. Professor, I understand that you look just like your grandfather, Hines, and that you like acting, reading, and singing. That you had... I can't read it, how do you... A guinea pig that's blessed you with five more, among which you buy in a jacuzzi. By her jacuzzi. That's how you like to sing in the mirror while shaving.
Steve Hall, his nickname is Stevie John. As a child of four, Mom writes us that you were very, very concerned that your scalp would fall off, and it happened. Stevie John, your folks write also that your endeavors in writing and photography have been an unexpected source of pleasure and pride. Mom is sure that a long-term contract with GQ or a glamorous life as a photojournalist is in your future. The movie that best describes your high school years, your folks wrote us, was Fatal Attraction. Stevie John, Mom writes that you look just like her and that you had a pet rat named JST. She also tells us that you really love your car and that college is in the immediate future and in general an independent life. And this great young lady that gets to be mom with these gentlemen, her nickname is Sunshine, she's Tracy Long. The childhood memory that your folks came up with was that you were always holding up your finger and asking everybody one more time, I want